My New Year's resolution, I only have one. Get even more jacked in 2021.
If possible.
On the very first day of 2021, President Donald Trump signaled the war that he will start within the Republican Party. Quote, I hope to see the great governor of South Dakota, Kristi Noem, run against Rhino Senator John Thune in the upcoming 2022 primary, he tweeted, adding, she would do a fantastic job in the U.S. Senate, but if not Kristi, others are already lining up. South Dakota wants strong leadership now, end quote. What offense had Thune, the number two Republican in the Senate, committed against Trump, you ask? Must be serious, right? Well, it certainly wasn't breaking with Trump's agenda over the past 4 years, as the South Dakota senator voted in line with President Trump's positions 92.9% of the time, according to calculations made by 538. Sidebar, that was the same score as Senate Majority Leader and Trump ally, Mitch McConnell. Yeah. What it appears Thune did to Trump is publicly acknowledge that Joe Biden won the 2020 election. Aren't we agreeing on that? Quote, I understand there are people who feel strongly about the outcome of this election, but in the end, at some point, you have to face the music, Thune told reporters at the U.S. Capitol, according to the New York Times, in December. Thune also later told CNN that the planned congressional objection to the Electoral College on January 6 would, quote, A, not succeed, and B, would put lots of Republicans in a terrible political position. Quote, I think the thing they got to remember is it's not going anywhere, Thune said on CNN last month, adding, I mean, in the Senate, it would go down like a shot dog. I just don't think it makes a lot of sense to put everybody through this when you know what the ultimate outcome is going to be, end quote. And now it seems that by stating these facts, Trump is actively encouraging Noem, the state's governor, and an ardent Trumper to take on Thune. And make no mistake, and this is important, this challenge isn't about ideology, as Trump seems to suggest in his tweet attacking Thune as a rhino, Republican in name only. Thune has spent much of the last 2 decades serving in the House and then the Senate from South Dakota and racking up a solidly conservative voting record. Here's an example. His American Conservative Union lifetime voting score is almost 85. Fellow South Dakota Senator Mike Rounds, another Republican, has a conservative score of approximately 75. So Trump's push for a primary challenge to Thune is solely about the president believing that the senator is not sufficiently loyal. And loyalty seems to be defined as supporting his baseless conspiracy theories about the election and or attempting to overturn the results by extra legal means. Now, Thune is not the first Republican elected official who Trump has threatened over a lack of loyalty. In the wake of his November defeat in Georgia, Trump has repeatedly pushed Republican Governor Brian Kemp, a Trump loyalist through and through, to find a way to overturn the results. When, after several recounts, Kemp said he had no way of changing the outcome, Trump attacked him and began casting around, yes, you guessed it, for a primary challenge to him in 2022. Quote, Doug, you want to run for governor in 2 years? Trump asked of Congressman Doug Collins at a rally for Senators Kelly Loeffler and David Perdue in advance of their January 5th runoff, adding of Collins, quote, he'd be a good-looking governor, end quote. The standard being set here by Trump is clear. If you don't support his fact-free attempts to overturn the election, he will cast you as not a real Republican, and he will work to find someone more loyal to him to take you on. Quote, the surrender caucus within the Republican Party will go down in infamy as weak and ineffective guardians of our nation who are willing to accept the certification of fraudulent presidential numbers, tweeted Trump in early January. All of which brings me to the debate and vote that's coming up in Congress over objections in regards to the Electoral College count. Now, that vote will almost certainly be used by Trump as a loyalty litmus test going forward. Either you vote with him and against, well, you know, a crazy little thing called democracy, or he will find someone to run against you the next time you are up for re-election. Quote, one of the GOP senators up for re-election in 22 acknowledged that voting against Trump may spur a primary challenge, tweeted Punch Bowl News' John Bresnahan in early January, adding, this is a problem for me, said the senator who asked not to be named, end quote. Yes, it is. Big time. Remember, too, that Senate Republicans already have plenty to worry about in 2022. They have to defend, as of today, 21 seats as compared to just 13 for Democrats. What Trump's threats against Thune and Kemp suggest is that the outgoing president is entirely comfortable ripping the Republican Party in two. One side filled with those who back him until the bitter end and beyond, and the other side populated by those who, well, don't. Which, if it comes to pass, is an utter disaster for the near-term and maybe middle and long-term future of the Republican Party. A fissure that creates a Trump party and a Republican Party would likely lead to losses up and down the ballot in swing seats and states, as there are simply not enough Republicans in the country to split themselves up and still win. Smart conservative minds like John Thune and Mitch McConnell understand this math. Trump either doesn't or doesn't care. Either way, what he is threatening to do to the Republican Party could leave it badly damaged for many years to come. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Be sure to check them all out.